guys, there is Yoda. Today's matches are going to be from one elimination tournament. It's going to be round 3 between the random and Jesse. There are going to be two games, Mordor vs Man of the West and Dwarf vs Mordor. So let's get started. Sorry, I haven't been uploaded recently, day by day, but I've been busy a bit. So I'll try to make it on the weekend and upload a little bit more, one video per day. We're gonna find out if it's going to work out for me. But anyway, let's get to the game. We got here on the north the random playing against Pink Mordor, throwing down Harad Palace and Slaughterhouse. And on the south we got Jesse, who is going to farm, and I'm suppose this builder is going to create forward barrack somewhere over here. Over here. Oh, it looks like it's going to be over here. Random just take the Eye of Sauron to scout his opponent. He's looking for the barrack near the Warkler. He even saw this, looking over here. Maybe even over here. If he even saw those barracks is over here, then he's going definitely on this side. And Harad Palace is up, Asterix almost come out, while Jesse got himself barrack not completed yet. So definitely it will be spotted even by Eye of Sauron, and this barrack will not get enough time to create any units. As we can see right now, barrack have been created and Gondor soldiers will be full down, but it doesn't make any sense as the rings are on the barrack already. They're going to be damaged. Good cancellation over here, good catch by D-Random. Jesse decided to leave his farm and create a barrack because he got no power, no forces on the field. Random is coming for the creep, get treasures and experience. Third farm for Jesse, of course barrack in progress. Level 2 Haradrim Palace to get access to Haradrim Archers. Pretty good idea when you're facing food units only at this point, like Random is. Random in the meantime, of course, going for another creep, take the treasures and experience. Jesse is going with Archer range. First battalion of soldiers of Gondor appear on the map, but I think it's definitely too late. This Warkler will be creeped and Random will get treasures from it for sure. Level 3 or Asterlings, he will get the treasures and most likely get away. We got Haradrim archers as well over here. They will definitely deal significant damage to those soldiers of Gondor. They're pretty good versus food infantry units, and let's take a look. One hit, one dead. And tower guards heading the left flank of Jesse's base with some archers. And I think Random will try to get this Warkler as well, so here we're gonna have some skirmish. Haradrim archers spotted Gondor archers, they will be definitely destroyed by them. Elven would have been thrown down, as well as Heavy Lie. Nazgul for Random up here. There is as well another battalion of Haradrim archers. And tower guards will be killed, and the treasure goes to Random, and here we see the waste of townland and forest for Jesse, so he got himself in a really bad spot and he's in really bad shape. He got no units, only 3 downside infantry units, some archers and the Harrowing Tower and Gondor Tower Guards. It's easily to killed by Haradrim archers. This is why Ranum is going with Haradrim archers more and more. As we can see, they deal a lot of damage to those tower guards. Get an experience and command points and power points for himself. In the meantime, Ranum catch a builder for Jesse and he just kill him. So Jesse started this game pretty badly. Stable is for Jesse at this point. It's not going to be honest work out that well. There is a very Haradrim Asterlings, I mean, in this composition with Haradrim archers. And Jesse got only 4 farms and the state of the game. All of them level 1. And he got troops in a bad shape, as we can say as well. Siege work will be thrown down by Ranum right over here. You should see the shadow of the barrack, and I think that Jesse will not come out from this position. He will stay over here. Maybe he should create some towers near the barrack over here and maybe attack with some Gondor archers from the tower. But at this point he is just stopped from producing units. Here comes some knights, and will they catch some units? Oh, they will catch some units, but those units are still alive. Knights almost killed. Here comes the Nazgul for Rano. That get away. Oh, now level 2 for knights. Good catch by Jesse over here. But barricade is thrown down, level 2 for siege works. How about power points at this point? 6 power points only for Jesse. So it's not enough for Tom Bombadil. 7 at this point. So it's not enough for Tom Bombadil or hobbits. But Nazgul have been killed. Ranum haven't paid attention. Jesse make an incredible job over here. He killed most of Haradrim archers with knights. That was pretty good. Ranum decided to go for tower near the base of his opponent. Good idea. In the meantime, he's attacking farms as well and lure his opponent to make them more damage. Catapults for Radob as well, so he will deal more damage. I'm sorry.
We guard the White Tower.
Here comes some Haradrim archers still. Land have been thrown down. How is Ranum response to this? He got 3 power points only. He need 2 more to get Townland to counter forest from his opponent. Barricade in danger. Oh, those knights can easily pick those catapults. Get Haradrims on them. Barricade have been destroyed.
Soldier battalion standing by.
Archers at the ready.
Haradrim archers will be killed over here. Here comes Corsairs. 10 power points for Jesse, so definitely we're gonna find and saw Tom Bombadil or hobbits over here. So there is a counter for Elfenrod. There is Tom Bombadil for Jesse. Is he going to use it right now? It could be a good idea. And here is the Tom Bombadil. All the units should get away. Pretty good micro by Random, I gotta say. No units lost to this Tom Bombadil yet. Sonic Song have been used and it was the waste. And Jesse retreated to the well to heal his units while Random got a problem. He will lose most likely the scaffold. And this is some slaughterhouses house to Tom Bombadil. Mabo Sauron appeared for Random. In the base, Random got mostly nothing, to be honest. Few slaughterhouses. He could create some Haradrim palace over here, and more taverns. He got money for it. Barricade will be available for Random in the time being. Another siege work will be for down on 10th land of Random. And Jesse got for himself some major forces. Another barricade will be thrown down. But I don't think so it will match the army size of Random. Plus, Random got for himself yet Evil Eye. And Tunland can cover land in the meantime. Can cover the Elfenwood. Oh, Nazgul with Micro, he will be killed and catched by tower guards. Bad Micro by Random, but it may happen sometimes. Good that Mabu Sauron is still alive. All the Corsairs have been beaten down by Knights. But there goes Barragan. An Archer Engine. Evil Eye, Eye of Sauron rather, have been used. Will have been destroyed, so lots of damage have been done by Random so far. He's trying to aim the fortress, pretty bad idea. Knights on the pikemans, almost all of them have been killed. Mabu Sauron get to retreat, but it's going to be too late, and yet fortress killed the Mabu Sauron. Random shouldn't try to take down this fortress at the moment. He could definitely kill all those units, all those archers that fired at him, but he's not going to do it. Level 2 siege works is about to be done. He will get siege works for Jesse. 10 power points for him as well. And yeah, Random decided to get away from the fortress or of his opponent. He saw that he's not about to destroy this fortress. He made it to the half of the health of this fortress, but doesn't make any sense to continue this and lose an advantage. Here comes another catapult for Random. Jesse with some fortress forces trying to protect the fortress all the time.
Let's get this trebuchet where we can use it.
Here comes catapult from both the players and trebuchet for both the players. Only 2 farms for Jesse, 1 level 3. And Random is going for the fortress, now nothing will stop him. We'll destroy some farms that Jesse create as well. Here comes some hobbits. but her rally marches definitely humiliate those Gondor archers. And I think it's over. The Cobalt will definitely destroy the fortress, even with Krakens from Hobbits. There's no way that the fortress will stay alive. And it's what's happened at the moment. Here comes Nazgul of Sauron, they retreated. So yeah, Tamland and Jesse decided to leave the game and be defeated. So game number one goes to the random. And let's check game number two. It's going to be Dwarf versus Men of the West. Here we go, the random as Pink Dwarf in the sound, and Mordor, Jesse has Mordor on in white. Jesse's going with a slaughterhouse and orc pit. He shouldn't do it when he spotted those this kind of composition. He definitely should go for two slaughterhouses and then like two or three orc pits to make the spam. Take down the tunnels, of course, spikes by the random. He will go for the creeps. While Jesse is going with the orcs, warriors, and here is another orc pit for this player. Here comes the pikemans, the fog, and random decided to creep the troll on the left side rather than on the right side. As well, he decided to create a mineshaft near the warclaw on Jesse's right flank. Here comes some orcs, they will catch the mineshaft. Good catch by Jesse over here. Here comes some archers, orc archers. Jesse realized that random is creeping the troller as well, but it's too late to intervene and to invert to stop it. The treasures and experience will go to pikes from random, most likely. And now we got some guardians, some other tunnel. Here are some orc warriors. Jesse is going with orc archers and orc warriors. They're definitely good against pikemen and guardians. So Jesse could be able to deal some damage if he's going to micro well with orc archers, definitely. Oh, it looks like it's what's going to happen. Eye of Sauron have been used as well. And random decided to get away, that he got no chance to beat this kind of composition. Another Guardians of Guardians battalion appear. Jesse decided to go with orc archers to the pikemans. They're not doing damage yet. Bad decision over here. He should go for those pikemans over here. And let's see how it's going. Rumble stayed over here. Random is going to destroy them. How many treasures Jesse is going to take? Only one. But I think it's good anyway for him. Forge work for random. dwarves with the for deal enough damage for those lots of orcs that appear on the map. How about Jesse? Jesse got only those two orc pits, and he retreated his builders to create another stuff. I think it's going to be Haradin Palace. Jesse is not creeping yet, he is not attacking fight with Munchafts enough. He doesn't have enough units as well, which is weird. Why you are Mordor and going with orcs, you definitely want to have more units than your opponent. As you can see, with two orc pits, it's not enough. Here comes Battle Wagon. Jesse got for himself a Nazgul. To deal with Guardians, most likely. Guardians are level 2 for random. He could use Charge Attack to deal damage to the Orc Archers. But it looks like it's not what's going to happen. Here comes first Battle Wagon for random. How many command points get both of the players? 4000 for Jesse, 400 for Jesse, and 450 for random. So they are pretty even. Battle Wagon easily taking down those orcs. Guardians easily pick orc archers and Nazgul get to get away. In the meantime, Jesse is creeping Warclair with Esterlings and some orcs. This looks like it's not enough. 5 power points almost for Jesse, 6 already for random. And he will get on the Battle Wagon X for worse. Deal some damage to the orcs and most likely get away. Not even trying to get a creep. Runicle have been used, but the Dread Visage from which for Nazgul will definitely take it down. Oh, Run goes through the enemy's base and for enemy's Haradin pass them at least. The slaughterhouses as well. There is a Battle Wagon level 2. Haradin Palace goes down. And another Haradin Palace will go down. Yes! Random catch it. So, a little bit losses by Jesse over here. A few slaughterhouses will go down by destroying by Battle Wagon. Guardians will most likely going to be killed. Yes, they are, but those two battalions stay alive on level 3, both of them. Battle Wagon level 6 at the moment. Another Battle Wagon level 1. Random is dealing damage to those slaughterhouses in the meantime, trying to creep, but he realized that his opponent is creeped already. The Warclair is on the middle. Random get away with his Battle Wagons, both of them still alive. And it looks like Random got 1k. He could get himself Gimli, glowing rather. But he decided to go through the middle. He'll be catched by major forces of orcs and receiving a builder for random by misclick. Here come some hobbits to change perspective of this game, as well as Battle Wagons. There is banner carry for Jesse and he will snipe those Battle Wagons pretty good. One of those Battle Wagons have been killed already. Another is retreating to the base.
The
to the Mannschaft. Oh, he's going to fight with Nazgul. No, he's trying to get away, but it's not going to work out, and Battlewagon have been catched by Nazgul. Jesse picked the builder as well, that was unfortunately over here for random. So Jesse's still in the game. How is his base going? Is he going to recreate his base? He's about to recreate his base. He got Mavus Sauron for himself as well. Haradin Palace have been recreated, but there comes those tower guards that will miss by our player, and Battlewagon will be most likely destroyed. Oh, yeah, it's some kind of bug over here. Battlewagon still alive for random. He goes running call on the guardians. Nazgul should get here to use Dread Visage. And it's what's happened. Maybe Orpid will go down? Not really, I don't think so. It's too late for Ran to deal damage with those guardians. Mav Sauron is trying to catch the Battlewagon, and he will succeed at catch the Battlewagon with Men of Dale on them. More orcs and Asterings. Haradin Palace have been destroyed one more time. But those two tower guards, Battlewagon have been destroyed and killed. Here is another Battlewagon. Two slaughterhouses on random space, to be honest. Pretty unusual to see. While Jesse haven't sustained even his base, look at the spots that he could throw down slaughterhouses over here or over here. He has nothing. And with Nazgul, and I guess Mavus Sauron, Jesse is trying to catch another Battlewagon. While with forces, and Mavus Sauron will catch those pikemen and guardians. He could use Eye of Sauron, definitely, but it's not needed at this point when you got two battalions of orc archers, one guardians and pikemen. So most likely he will catch the money. A little bit mismicro by Jesse over here. He get out from the spam of orc warriors that will get to the catch the damage. But Jesse would get the money and most likely should get away from those guardians. There is no sense to fight with them. Jesse is not going for any large troops, he's not upgrading, he's going only for Starlings and Orcs. Which at this point of the game shouldn't be a thing, he should definitely go for something else, something more. Mavus Sauron dealing damage to the mineshaft. In the meantime, barricade is going down. Jesse got another barricade available for him. And he's throwing it down near the fortress, which is a good idea when your defense is sloppy. And you most likely vent your base for the third time. And for the third time, Haradin Palace will go down. Three Battlewagons with Axe Throwers on them from random. But Mavus Sauron got Eye of Sauron and it's going to be used. And two Battlewagons have been catched by this heavy lie. Here comes Glon on level 4, level 3 at the moment, almost level 4. But now it's level 4. So Shake Redemption is available for him. Troll creep. haven't been yet done. As well as for the cave troller. While trying to catch army from Jesse on the left side. So random is most likely everywhere. On the map right now, he get the treasures, he get lots of mineshafts. And 1k command points available for him. Even undermined. Which is good to use when you, for example, get the battle wagon over here. And use undermined with those large forces. It could be done. This looks like random is not going for this type of strategy yet. There's a Mother Sauron, some orcs and orc archers. This battle wagon most likely will be destroyed. One punch, we'll another punch, and this battle wagon is gone. But still, random is going with some forces and Gloin to deal damage to the slaughterhouses. He haven't yet used the undermined. He just based on his troops and his builder to build mineshafts.
We'll call for some guardians.
How many units he got in those mineshafts for himself? He got archer range available. Not much. Undermine have been used over here. All the units have been flied. Here comes the units for random.
I've got a wagon ready here.
He got a people Hobbit alliance, what he's already used. With Hobbits, he's going for Orc Bed pretty fast to destroy. Rankle have been used. There's lots of barricades over here, but Random is able, I think, to destroy the worm up here. So it's pretty much changer over here. Jesse will clear this up. And maybe even randoms will be killed. Not really, he will be healed. He destroyed one of those bits yet, one of the tower, and he will try to get away, retreat. Why this worm is out of control. Heavy light have been used. But I think it's not enough damage done by Mouth Sauron to kill this Gloin. Oh, it looks like Gloin will be killed by worm anyway.
Gather some axes, dwarves!
In the meantime, battle wagons having fun with orc spam. Almost no Esternics, nothing at the base of Jesse at this time being, only two barricades and one lone tower from the fortress. Avila is unavailable. And Gimli up here for random.
Gather some axes, dwarves.
More axe throwers, more pikes, more battle wagons.
We've got a wagon ready here. The phalanx will bring some order.
Here they come.
Gather some axes, dwarves.
Slaughterhouse goes down. Another one over here. Rankle have been used, all those forces of random. Jesse's farm is going down. Maybe random should take care about those barricades at the time being. on this barricade. I have to go down. Orc archer's got a problem. White will appear. I think. Yes, white has appeared to give damage to the units.
Out of the way!
Axe wars are secured. Here comes the bath wagon, but another one have been catched by the barricade. He was glowing, who trying to throw down axe war to this Nazgul. We get the worm killed, and with the leadership that glowing provide 50% armor for units, he could be able to destroy everything he need. Of course, he won't level him up to level 5 to get from him a slayer ability. Here comes Maw of Sauron.
Here they come!
From level 5.
Watch out!
Gather some axes, dwarves!
Lots of troops and a mine shaft for random, so he's waiting for the undermine to use it. Another axe throw on Nazgul. Nazgul is still alive, barely. Lip have been wasted by random as well, because Jesse decided to get away with units on time. Here is an undermine. It's going to be used over here. Oh, not really, looks like it could be used over here right now to pick up those units.
We'll
level 4 for Gimli. There comes some forces as well.
Gather some axes, dwarves.
Level 6 for Maw of Sauron. Undermite is available. Used to provide 50% damage and 50% of experience. And here it comes, undermined with major forces appear on the map. Two barricades for Jesse, but they're not going to stay long, as you can see. Another Harrowing Pass will be destroyed. Barricade expansion on the fortress as well will be destroyed from both sides, and randoms go for the fortress. It looks like that most likely this game is over. Lip will be used. X-Row should be used as well on Maw Sauron, and it's going to happen. Level 5 on Gimli, and here is the Slayer ability for him. Fortress Heaven goes down by Jesse, and random take the series 2-0. It was round 3 from One Day Elimination Tournament. Thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.